It's going down. I'm feeling tremors. You gotta pack. You gotta go. So yeah, so this is the second tremor this morning. It is now, I don't know what time it is, maybe 8 o'clock or something. But yeah, this is the second tremor. So I'm gonna get going. Let's go and have a look at that side of the island. Let's see if we can catch some volcano. That's the best case scenario. Worst case scenario is all of this that you see basically comes down, and then yeah, mega tsunami, which is not good. Let's go fill up the tank. It's alright, bud. So that's the volcano that's gonna pop.
Yep.
Yeah, that's the flow. I've walked up that flow before. Ah, okay.
You can start the hiking trail here.
I think the police might not let us go through. Let's see. No, they will. Gonna keep up the masquerading when there's the actual emergency. We have the planes flying. Okay, there she blows.
Jonathan!
Whoop whoop! And this. Okay. Hey, how are you doing? So this is my first volcano. There she blows. So I just hope my wife isn't... Where is my wife? Yeah, that's also the timing is a bit out. You know, the Jewish numerologist said the 1st of September. So the prediction is close. Wow. So hi, hello everyone there. We have liftoff. there's been a rumbling in the tummy of Earth for the last couple of years, and La Palma has decided to erupt. You know, it was kind of predicted. You know, the Jewish numerologist said it would be the 1st of September, but you know, they were wrong. But yeah, there we go. So we live round about there. Okay, so everyone is evacuating. And so, so are we. Let's do this.
So we're going to our place, right?
Yeah. I guess it's actually more important now because adrenaline and people. I can feel the panic in the
meeting.
Mostly the great flood that is the issue, you know, because, yeah, beautiful place though, eh?
Yay! Volcano buddies, yeah!
It's either fire or, is it called brimstone?
No idea.
I don't know. Babel always goes on about brimstone, fire and brimstone, so maybe this is brimstone. No. It's amazing that the cloud is so white though.
It just means it's just vapor, water vapor.
Exactly.
Yeah.
And I think it will change with time.
Yeah. My cousin is a rock doctor. So he'll be quite excited about some of this footage. Like a fire. So I'm one of the I'm in the volunteer chat, but I didn't have internet today. So, be careful with this, guys. Wrong way. Should we signal him down? Like, dude, going wrong way, fight man.
But it looks like
we're the only ones that are going into towards the. Don't worry, I've got a very good risk analysis. Although that is a little bit coming towards us, isn't it? Well, in any case, I love my wife. Don't get my wife.
Good of a video or picture you can take, probably.
It's also likely the first pop has gone off, and now it's just it was predicted, actually, you know what, the evacuation point would have changed, right? Because they predict, well, not they, the council, whatever, the numerologist said it was going to be, yeah, the other one said it's going to be closer to the other side. Okay. I don't have time to explain. You almost went the wrong way, right? Or do you drive on the right in Poland? There's a volcano.
It's
totally exploding. Exactly. That's a technical term.
Ah, volcano! She blows.
Yeah, I'm gonna go chase it. Thank you. Dos huecos, dos.
Sí.
Ay, ay, ay.
Por incendio.
Incendio todo. Sí. También mis coche. Mis coche aquí. Sí. Policías dicen no. No pasa. Sí. Vive aquí. Sí. No. Dos minutos. Sí.
Joshua.
Sí. Aurora. Mas solo dos antes a Puerto Naos y la laguna y todo. Right, so the volcano has popped behind us. It's pretty nice. But yeah, we should probably start moving and leaving. So that's what I'm gonna do.
What is now danger is that it's the fire.
Yeah. Yeah,
because the volcano is there, you know. This is not,
yeah,
not far away, but just there. So this is the, but you see on the other side the wood, the forest,
yeah,
is burning. So this is
hey everyone, this is Louis Labert and Louis Summers. I'm reporting here from El Paso in the Canary Islands, in the island of La Palma, La Isla Bonita. And as you can see, we have a volcano erupting behind us. This was predicted, you know, by numerology and also by a seismologist. So yeah, it's kind of cool. We've got an evacuator, so this will be just a quick video, but I'll leave it running for a bit while things are getting ready. And yeah, it's rumbling.
Footage!
So based on the wind direction coming this way with the fire, I think we're gonna go. So. Mama, she's not gonna stand for the shit. Yoga shala and dome. Swimming pool. Finca Aurora. So the biggest threat isn't really this volcano, it is the landslide. So there's been predictions for a landslide here that you know, could cause waves up to 100 meters in height, starting point here. But luckily where we're standing now is about 650 meters above sea level. However, the surrounding islands will have a problem, as well as by the time the wave hits New York and London and these places. London, I think it would be about 60 meters high, and New York about 30 meters high. So everyone knows this, the Canary Islands are fabled to be, you know, the seven tops of old Atlantis. From myths and legends, hey? But that's definitely, that's quite busy. I don't know if you can hear it. So this morning at 7:30, we felt an earthquake. And then, oh, this is getting much louder. What does my intuition say? Safe. Seminars and things that will be held over here, but yeah, sadly you can see in the distance that there's fires starting with the lava flow. So this particular lava flow, that particular break, you know, I've walked before, and it's really cool. It's really nice. A lot of people don't understand magnetism, you know, or the energetic body. But over here, if you just bring your Kindle and your Kindle cover has magnets, you will see what I mean. Wow. So I'm not sure if you can hear the sound, but it goes like whoosh, whoosh. It's like waves. There's a big fire there at the bottom starting. So that area where it actually erupted is called Las Manchas. Oh, shame. The yurt I lived in will probably be burnt. I hope Catherine's okay. How you doing, man? You good? Alles glad?
Yeah.
Alles glad. That's German for everything's good, with a Berlin accent. Oh, so the places that were evacuated is down there. And that is called Porto Naus. Where at 1 o'clock this afternoon, after the third earthquake, we just wanted to go and have a swim. But then on the way there, the roads were already blocked and people were evacuated. So instead we went for some food at a vegan place called Palmarita Cafe. And then when I was there, that's when we just heard poof, and looked around and saw this. So yeah, it's doing its eruption there. It'll probably be more spectacular at night, but I don't think we're gonna risk that. There was a curious video, if you can go and look on the internet, it said 1st September 2021, La Palma Cumbrecita landslide. So that was a prediction. It's not that far out, but I'm not really feeling the earth move more than the three earthquakes. But this is a spectacular place. So the good news is it is not a very big inhabited area. You know, some of the seismologists thought that the eruption might happen in Fuencaliente, which is more to the south, where there are a lot of people, versus you know, Las Manchas is there's not a lot of people who live there. And also the Palmeros, the Canarians, you know, they are hardy people. The previous eruption, I think 1971 or something, the locals just continued in Fuencaliente, the local farmers just continued picking the wine, picking the grapes, making the wine. Guanxi. And ancient knowledge.
Täällä vihaisena purkautuvan Tenegian lähiympäristössä kasvaa Fuencalienten kuulu malvasia viini. Sato oli juuri kypsynyt ja uskaliaimmat viljelijät kiiruhtivat palstoilleen pelastamaan makeat rypäleet viinipuristimiensa turvaan. Fuencalienten viini suikertaa maata myöten matalina ja kiemuraisina varsina. Laavasora on erittäin hyvä kasvupohja, sillä huokoisena se säilöi sadevettä. Vanhat tulivuoren rinteet maksavat täällä 6 markkaa neliömetri. Mukana oli myös Doña Juana, Kanarian rohkein nainen ja ensimmäinen naistaksikuski.
So yeah, feel free to share this video, especially if you know someone in the Canaries, or also if you know anyone interested in yoga, meditation, good life, good food, adventure, because this island is full of hiking trails. It is also the only island that I'm aware of in the world that passed the locals passed a declaration of access to the night sky. So there's no airplanes that fly over this island, which is great in many for many many reasons. And one of those reasons is the fact that you can see the stars every night, if it's not full moon or cloudy, which it's not often. Also, the locals here on this island, the Guanxis, they always planted vegetables and gardening by the moon, so they use moon calendars. And That's something you can go and investigate. Gardening by the moon. And it works. Yeah. There's a time and a place for everything. Let the moon be your guide. There she blows. Good old Pachamama. Always in flux. We need to go. All right. Of course we do. So sadly, there's the fires that are starting, and that sucks. We've got a Telegram and a WhatsApp group for the firefighting here, but I mean, I'm not gonna go into that as a volunteer, not today. But there's the fire starting, and that is a shame. So these pine trees, they are extremely resilient though, you know, the houses burn down around them, everything burns down around them, but they stay. So even that one that's on fire right now, you know, the bark is so thick. These trees are spectacular. If you go and lie down underneath them, you'll understand. Or you'll comprehend. So also the fire brigade and the ambulances and the Guarda Civil, you know, they went past here. So they're already fighting it over there. So this is on the magical island of La Palma in the Canary Islands. Here we have our yoga shala, a yoga dome, and mindful movements. And there's on that side is the city or the town of El Paso, and Los Llanos is past that, but behind me we have the volcano. So people down the line of that lava flow has been evacuated. The dust cloud is quite spectacular. You can see the first bit that's just water vapor, you know, the white. but then the lower you get, you know, it's now starting to and I'm not sure if you can hear, really can hear, it sounds like waves. So there's two holes, as we've been told. And there we have a drone, which I'm not sure whose that is. Yo, hello Lizelle. Thanks everyone for watching. So on behalf of the tourism of La Palma and the Canary Islands, I would like to invite all nice people who want to make a big change in the world, eco-sociology wise, consciousness wise. And as an alternative to the Great Reset, to come on over, maybe not right now, you know, but soon. So again, this whole cloud that's here is you know, the water vapor. This is the beautiful island, La Isla Bonita, also with the name La Palma. In 20 years from now, it will be known as like the Copangang of the Canaries. Why? Because we're building it. A nice sound. Pick me some figs. The island is also known for its plátanos. Los plátanos son muy buenos. The bananas are very nice. But if you do come and visit, please only support the eco, the biological plantations. And there are quite a few, many of them. One of them is called I think it's called La Plantación. Yeah. It's near Puerto Naos. It's run by a man called Manuel. And let's just say it is not just a plantation. I recommend you come late afternoon and spend a long time. Some banana liqueur while you're at it. So there's a drone going into the fire and brimstone. Turns out filming without a tripod is exhausting for your arms. But I would like to thank Jules from Pimp My Car that taught me some of these skills. If you're watching, thanks Jules.
Jules Watson.
So those watching, that's concerned. If there are no family or people here, I think it's all good. Those in Las Manchas got evacuated earlier today. We had three earthquakes, one at 7:35, the one that woke me up. Then another one at 8:15, 8:16. And then we had another one at about 1:32, 1:33. Sorry, 13:33. Yeah. Where my prediction was 3:33, but considering, if you understand how this and whatever this island's time zone is incorrect based on actual observation, but still, it means it went off 4 hours early. Unless I need to maybe get out of here, depending on the time now. Because the danger here really isn't these lava flows, unless you're in its path. The danger is this, at least computer models, right? So there's computer models that say if this cumbrecita breaks off, we will get a similar flood, you know, that happened. Well, theoretically happened, possibly happened, mythologically happened. Circa 13,000 years ago. Yeah. So that's what's happening that side. Here we have yoga and body work, so that's like massage, kinesiology, I guess, all the other things to do with moving your body, healing your body. You know, we've got some gymnastics rings in there as well, swimming pool for some, I don't know what you call it, but it's something you can do. Come and find out. This place is called Finca Aurora, where I'm staying at the moment. They're really great. They've set up a co-working space. They have this one as well as Musicasa, the house of music. If that resonates with you, you understand what I mean. There we have some officials going towards, that was a big one. So it's all quite fitting. Last night I created my company, Interdependence, which is all about these type of things, as well as solutions using or for water, earth, fire, wind technology, sun, and heart or ether. If you go and read some 19th century physicists' work. Wow, yeah, it's kind of nice. Ooh, wow. Right, so as you can see, that's quite spectacular. That's kind of cool. So I hope you enjoy this. On the bottom of this video, in the comments or in the description, I'll put some details of lapalma.works, which is the website for remote working, especially during these restrictive times. There are solutions, you know, people are creating all the solutions around the world, you know, for to help people continue working and earning their own income, as well as thriving. So the website is www.lapalma.works, and you know, it's a collaboration between different spaces here. Hey Claudia, hope you're good. So for those who don't know where the Canary Islands are, you know, maybe you know or have heard of Tenerife or Lanzarote. So those are more the party islands, where there's like three of the islands here. They are more the spiritual or the eco or the adventure islands. So we've started up a bit of a rock climbing group over here. We are trying to grow that as well. So my cousin is a rock doctor, as I call him. haven't spoken for a while, I know about this. But I think you'll be interested in this. But also, man, I want to ask you some things about how much you know about structured water. And which stones would be best. So this whole cloud here, as you can see, it's still expanding. That is, you know, from the eruption. That was the initial just you know, water vapor. And these you know, this explosion that was about 1:30 this afternoon. No, that's not true. Two o'clock after lunch. Alright, so I guess I'm gonna now actually go. But get in touch, you know who you are, you know what we need to do. So stop messing about and make life awesome.
se quedan medio atrapados.
Hello family, so I can see sort of by the Cumbre Vieja Volcano, my big afgegaan for the day. So ons is hier so, ons is so lekker swembad tussen my en die vulkaan. And also kan julle sien die lava flows. It's pretty cool, pretty epic. So we finally found a good use for the Mars. These particles are actually big enough to be stopped. So yeah, enjoy. This is just fantastic. Completely believable. And here we have ash cloud. Erupting, and to the right we have the lava flows. We have this really spectacular ash cloud, well, ash and water vapor. and trauma.
Trauma?
Yeah. Use two fingers to zoom in.
Yeah, the lava is going strong, but it's turned out to be a beautiful evening. Okay, this is the ash cloud. Okay, right there. So it's really quite something. Decide to come this way, we'll probably also
move a couple of miles
further away, because that mount, that's a new mountain that is popping up there. Before it was just, you know, the hill was that, so that'll be very cool to go and climb in a couple of months, I guess, or maybe a year or so. So I have one, two friends, you know, who will most likely lose their houses. But they prepare for stuff like that. And we're a strong community over here. So it's there's lots of space. There's lots of space on this planet, people. Don't fall for the lie. Just get out of your cities. You'll see. All right, good night.
So, good morning.
I'm just waking up here. Is that even working? Ah, maybe not when you're filming, I guess. So,
you know, you might wonder why we have the bottles of gas outside. And it might have something to do, you know, with, what the hell? So yeah, so there we have the volcano. It's pretty freaking epic, I've got to say. It's not nothing. Okay. Once in a... Okay, also that mount that you see over there, that is new. So before that, it's only the bottom silhouette, or the first line of trees that was there yesterday, and then everything after that is new earth, new land. But also sadly, the lava flow that's going goes all the way that goes to the right. That it's taken a bit of properties. Also, a lot of animals have been displaced. A lot of pet animals have been displaced.
know, the wild animals, they kind of know what to do. So yeah, enjoy the show, best show on earth. This is the best game in town. Got up some breakfast, then maybe gonna do a little bit of stretching. What else? More filming. Enjoy. So good morning, everyone. Got the volcano still going on. Now this is a spectacular island. We have the news crew, the helicopter at the top. Having a look what the situation is. Got the sun rising, sun coming up. Got the sun coming up. Like it's lined up. Volcano. And I don't usually resort to psychoactive beverages first thing in the morning, but I thought I would I'd make a little bit of an exception. Yeah, coffee is psychoactive. That's not a opinion. Yeah, that's just how it works. Get the in. And update on how's it going with the lentil sprouts. Nice, they're coming on. So I'm just gonna filter some water, give them a quick another flush, and then we'll see how they do tomorrow. Morning, yeah, volcano is still going off, sun is still rising as the sun does, and I want to quickly show you something that you might have seen your grandma do, and a lot of people living in cities have just forgotten these skills. And the one is, you know, that filtered water, you know, the unadulterated water that you used last night to make your potatoes. You know, let it cool out overnight. And then help out your friends. The next morning, I've seen the palmeros, you know, these are the people from La Palma. I've seen them do this, the grand old ladies. So yeah, you know, reuse, reduce, recycle, hey?
Oh yeah, oh yeah, oh yeah, oh oh.
Oh yeah, oh yeah, oh yeah,
oh oh. We are, we are, we are, oh oh. We are, we are, we are, oh oh. Om Gam Ganapataye Namaha. Om Gam Ganapataye Namaha. Om Gam Ganapataye Namaha.
That's a song by Satsang, which means community, not as in the politician's idea of big community, but in actual village life community. Mama is active today. will come to us.
Yeah,
it has a really, really deep groove for it to go in. There's the sun. And it is being blanketed out a bit. We have clouds, but a lot of this is actually from the ash cloud. We can see the ash cloud. Luckily, the wind is also blowing that way. Again, I might evacuate if the wind changes. There's ash on the road now. You can hear it. Social media says it's the end of the world. But remember the difference between news and reality. It's just another day in paradise. Very important to distinguish between reality and news. Critical thinking skills are required. So enjoy the spectacle. It's really beautiful. All of life is beautiful. Birds are chirping away. Also quite excited about all the happenings. There's where the lava flow finishes. And here is where life continues. So there's a bit of ash on the road, not so much on this point, as it depends on how much the wind is blowing. There we go. Again, these houses on this side is safe. No, it's not nuclear fallout or anything like that. This ash is most likely just extremely fertile. It's still spectacular.
I talked with him and he said he's waiting.
Que dicen que